Hello and welcome to Animal Sciences 207. For our first lecture video, we will be discussing the domestication of companion animals. The learning objectives are a summary of the key concepts you should be familiar with after every lesson. These are topics that are very likely to reappear on exams, quizzes, projects, etc. Use this list as a guide when developing study materials for yourself. Our objectives for this week are to learn the basics of the taxonomic classification system, learn why different species were first domesticated. We want to find out the progenitor species for the dog and cat, the criteria for domestication, the effects of domestication, and the differences between domestication and taming. So, before we really dive into this week's super cool topic of domestication, we need to have a short discussion of taxonomy. Taxonomy, as defined by the Merriam-Webster Online Dictionary, is the orderly classification of plants and animals according to their presumed natural relationships. Taxonomy is not an exact science by any means, and much argument exists in the field over how to correctly classify living things. Once based solely on behavioral and aesthetic similarities between different living organisms, taxonomy is now employing the ability to sequence genomes and decode DNA in order to determine relationships between species. Essentially, the levels of classification start with very wide sweeping categories. The broadest category is domain, with each subsequent category becoming more and more specific until it is narrowed down to a single species, and in some cases a subspecies if they exist. So let's use the red fox as an example. We go from the domain Eukarya, which encompasses everything from plants to single-celled organisms, down to the kingdom Animalia, which narrows it down to animals. Then we progress to the phylum Chordata, which includes every animal with a backbone. Next, the class Mammalia for mammal, then the order Carnivora for carnivore, and then foxes are in the Canidae family along with wolves, coyotes, dogs, etc. The genus Vulpes includes all the different kinds of foxes. Then the species name, which also happens to be a vulpes. So the animal referred to as Vulpes vulpes is the red fox. Taxonomic classifications help us make sense of the living things we share our world with. Paired with taxonomic classification, familiarity with the domestication history of animals will help us understand the foundations upon which our deeply ingrained bond with them was forged over thousands of years. You guys are going to watch a short video on taxonomy, and then we will get back together for another discussion.